All right, it's 5:43, so I know it's dinner time. I mean, a lot of y'all are probably in the kitchen right now making something. Some meals, though, they're quick, they're easy, and they're cheap, and a lot of kids might be filling up on them during the summer break. We are talking about all of those convenient processed foods that have really come to dominate the U.S. diet, but they've been linked to higher rates of cancer and early death.
Rosemarie Beltz is in the studio now to talk about how researchers have found the first evidence linking these prepackaged foods to growing waistlines and obesity. I guess right out of the gate to our viewers at home.
Sure.
Simply put, what are processed foods?
So pretty much all the food we eat here in the United States is altered or changed in some way before we get it, unfortunately. And so health experts, they classify the food we eat into four categories, right, in the nation. It's minimally processed food or whole foods. Then we're going to jump to processed culinary foods, which are foods basically that you think of like butter, butter, lard, things to that nature. And then we're starting to step it up where we start adding salt to food. And where, we start getting into processed food, whether that's even just salted peanuts, things like that that you want to think about. Mm. And then this ultra processed food is this food that's full of all these additives, probably these chemicals that you can't pronounce
right.
in some way.
Right. Like I'm aware when I take the powder of the mac and cheese and I pour it in and I add water, that's not like really food.
No, it's convenient, but it's right. not food, unfortunately.
Well, we've been hearing a lot about processed food is bad, not to eat it. Is that still what this study found? Don't eat the processed food?
Yeah, pretty much. So what made this study pretty exciting is for researchers is that usually we're always looking at mice when it comes to food studies, and because we can control mice and what they eat in a controlled environment. This specific study had 20 adults, 10 men, 10 women, half of them ate processed food, half of them ate whole foods. So it was really a controlled environment. And what they found was in less than 2 weeks, you started seeing significant changes to your waistline, started gaining weight, and some of those hormones that control hunger. So less than 2 weeks.
So
wow.
I shouldn't be going to Wendy's and McDonald's every day?
No, unfortunately. So with that being said, I know it's hard to cook every single night, but just try to cook once, maybe eat
and
five
eat it
times.
For a couple days.
Because in this study, it was calorie for calorie, carb for carb. So basically what that means is that the meals were made up of the same components as far as carbs, fat, fiber, etc. But they were in different forms, whether it was a salad with chicken or a processed chicken salad.
We're looking at some great ideas now about how we can incorporate these things in our home. Tell us a little bit about some of these things, like looking for heart healthy labels and doing meal prep and snacking smarter.
Exactly. Plant a garden. It's summer. Kids really like to eat what they grow, so that would be something to get them to eat more fruits and veggies. But the bottom line is, it's really hard to get all those processed foods out of our diet all the way. But if we can just try to cook in advance, maybe oatmeal once and eat that, serve it, during the week, because they're even seeing processed foods are, even some of these cereals that you're feeding your kids. So it's really just try to be prepared as much as you can.
Honey Nut Cheerios do not grow on trees, but they're so delicious.
Not much honey in those Honey Nut Cheerios.
All right, something to definitely think about as you're getting ready for dinner tonight. Thank you so much, Rosemarie.
Sure thing.
All right, stay with us. We have more Friends at 5 coming.